Well, if you were there and can't remember them, or if you missed them by a couple of years, you can revisit the 60s again this Sunday. This is the sound of 60s psychedelia, Hogtown style, the Ugly Ducklings, one of many such bands that inhabited the clubs of Yorkville for a decade from the early 60s to the early 70s. Now, the Ducklings are getting together with some of their old marquee mates, including Dominic Triano, Luke and the Apostles, Robbie Lane and the Disciples, and Lighthouse. It's called the Toronto Rock Revival.
We make it difficult for modern sound technicians, not because we still turn everything up full. Because that's what we're used to.
Yeah.
Oh, the hearing.
What?
What was that?
Pardon. The Ducklings only lasted a couple of years. They didn't make any money, but became cult stars around the world thanks to bootleg recordings. Others from those days did go on to the big time. Neil Young, Rick James, John Kay and Steppenwolf. But most, like the Ducklings, stayed in town. Some stayed in music. Others branched out to careers as diverse as mechanic or in television production.
Whatever happens, we have more respect from other people now than we had back then. Back then, they used to kick us out of restaurants because we looked too dirty and, you know, disgusting to serve.
In the last 20 years, the Ducklings have played together 30 or 40 times. There are fewer fistfights amongst band members these days, and they have more money. The Ducklings prefer to remember the good times.
A lot of other people don't have something like this that can keep them in their youth. That, to me, music just keeps me in my youth.
The Ugly Ducklings play Sunday night at the Warehouse. And they're a great band, too, on top of all that.
What is their advice to young people, Johnny?
They say go into it for the love. Don't go into it for a rock star. In their case, they say they got into it to meet girls, and they said some of that happened, but they didn't end up making the money.